Hello students, today we are going to discuss very interesting topic, conversational skills, and we'll see two dialogues, dialogue number 9 and 10 of your textbook. See students, conversational skills is very important for all of us, and if we acquire this, our professional and personal dealings become easier. We can express ourselves in a better way, and that's why we can communicate. If we can communicate in a better way, we can express ourselves in better way, and that's why along with all the textbook lessons and grammar, we thought to teach you some basic conversational skills and some dialogues in particular situations, what you should speak and how you should speak. That's why we have all set of 15 dialogues in your textbook. Today we'll discuss dialogue number 9 and 10 out of all those 15 dialogues. So let's see here the conversational skills, and we'll deal with dialogue writing. Why do we need to acquire these skills? What is the importance? See, conversation is a way to express yourself. When you speak, then only you'll be able to tell others what you are and what you want to say. It enhances your technical skills. You might be technically very sound, but until and unless you speak out, how would you convince people? Tomorrow you will be going to face an interview. You are very good engineer, but then if you can't express it at that particular point in that particular interview, then who would believe that you are a very good engineer? You need conversational skills to enhance your technical skills. Your good communication is key to success and career growth. I am sure all of you would agree to this, that the better you communicate, there are more chances of your success and career growth. If you want to acquire better conversational skills, what you should do? Here are some practical tips for you. You need to learn to be interested in your fellow human beings, because ultimately these are the people with whom you are going to communicate. So be interested in them. Be polite and ask in a pleasant way, not as if you are investigating. Whenever you are talking to somebody, whenever you indulge in any kind of dialogue with anybody, you need to be very polite, gentle, and your manners need to be pleasant. Never ask somebody as if you are interrogating them like police. Never be interested in somebody's life up to such an extent that they feel that it is a disturbance. Ask the proper questions, and questions and replies should be related to the topic. Never beat about the bush, nothing personal about it. Whatever the topic given to you, or whatever professional, if you are in a professional dealing, whatever is asked, be specific in giving replies. Keep the conversation short. We have seen people who keep on speaking, and at the end of 15 minutes, even then they have not made themselves clear. This is not the right way. We need to be very brief, concise, and even then specific. Maintain eye contact during the conversation. That speaks of your confidence. Always do that. Listen and do not monopolize the conversation. Show your partner that you are also interested on his opinion about the topic of conversation. Some people are so fond of talking that they never give somebody else a chance to speak. Do not be like them. Give somebody chance, hear their opinion, and then talk about your own feelings. But then conversation always is a two-way process. Do not make it a one-way. Be knowledgeable. You can speak only and only if you have knowledge sound knowledge of that particular topic. So be knowledgeable about your subject, about the topic about which you are discussing. Always remember to show respect, be very mannerful, respectful. Learn to read or interpret body language and act confident. But students, this is not all. The conversation skills are a part of spoken English, but in your curriculum, we have dialogue writing, which is a part of your exam too. It involves your written English too. So when we are talking of dialogue writing, then you need to take care of these things too. Things to remember when writing a dialogue. You will be asked to write a dialogue about one particular topic which will be given to you in exam, and it would carry 7 marks. So you need to prepare your dialogue writing very well. It would give you 7 marks. That's why here I have noted down the things to remember when you are writing your dialogue. Write it as realistically as possible. Do not write about impossible situations or something which may sound very, very imaginary. Don't do it. Be realistic. Make it clear who is speaking when. Do not give too much information or unrealistic information in dialogue. That is, in one, make your dialogues short. Do not try and make it paragraphs. Keep the conversation moving. Both of them should speak. So whenever you are writing a dialogue, you will write, one character will write 1 or 2 sentences. Then again, it would be chance of other. That way you should keep it moving. It's not that the whole paragraph is of one speaker and then the other speaker only speaks thank you or how are you. It's not a dialogue. Make it as easy to read as possible. Always, the best English is the simplest English. So make it easy. Do not indulge in complexities or false verbosism. Need to take care of this grammar tips also. Put quotation marks around the words that actually come out of a person's mouth when you are talking about, when somebody speaks something, or when you are suggesting that particularly this sentence was spoken by somebody. Put the punctuation marks, quotation mark. Punctuation goes inside the quotation. Use commas or full stops after dialogue text depending on where they are in the sentence. Wherever is needed, use the proper punctuation. Capitalize the first word of what the person says. As such, this is something very common, but I just thought of reminding you. That's why. Start a new paragraph each time a person speaks. Every time a new dialogue will start with new paragraph. Now, we are here to discuss 2 dialogues of your syllabus, and concentrating on dialogue 9 of your textbook. Your dialogue 9 of our textbook Active English speaks of holiday plans. 2 people are talking about their holiday plans. See this dialogue. Then here is a dialogue in front of you. And how do we speak this dialogue? Let's see.
Situation 9. Holiday plans. You visit many places during your holidays. Let's learn what and how to talk about your holiday plans. Here is one such dialogue.
What have you planned for your holiday?
I am going to Goa this October.
Wow, it's a beautiful place with amazing beaches. I went there 2 years back. I had lots of fun.
Yes, the weather there will be perfect in October.
How long will you be away?
I am planning a 5-day trip.
Good. You'll be completely relaxed. Are you taking your family along?
Yes, my parents and brother.
How are you going? By train or by air?
By train. We have booked our tickets. How about you? Going anywhere?
No, not this time. My cousins are coming to stay with us.
It sounds exciting.
Yes, we plan to go for shopping and eat out most of the time. There are so many shopping malls I have not visited yet.
And yes, during the vacation time, there will be many discount offers.
We have also planned to visit the Science City.
It's really good. You will enjoy with the group there.
Any new movie releases?
I'm not sure.
Anyway, enjoy your vacation in Goa.
I'm sure I will. And you too. Have a good time with your cousins.
This is the end of the dialogue. When one would ask you a question like, "What do you do on a holiday?" you would give the following answers.
I like reading. I like traveling. I like playing carom. I like relaxing. I like cooking.
Please note that exactly after the verb like, another verb comes with ing form, that is the present participle.
When one asks, how will you go there? You would answer by saying,
we will go there by air or by plane. We will go there by bus or by road. We will go there by train or by railway.
Please note that when we mention the means of transport, the preposition by is used before them.
Now, if we see the presentation, students, just now what you saw was the textbook dialogue was on your screen and you have heard how to speak that. Two people are discussing their holiday plans. That's what you have heard. The text is with you. When we are discussing about holiday plans, then I would like to give you some more information about the same. See, whenever you are talking to somebody about your plan, somebody would always ask you this question: where are you going on your next holiday? What are your plans for this summer? Or for that matter, if you want to discuss with somebody about their holiday, you should also ask this type of questions. You should begin with where, because where speaks of the place. That's why. Where are you going on your next holiday? Or what are your plans for this summer? Students, you may be asked a question like, your exams are over and how are you planning to spend your summer vacation? So, in all those kind of questions, you can begin your answers with holiday plans. And then, that's why this dialogue, particular dialogue, is very important to you. So, I am trying to give you some more inputs on the same. You have a text with you, you have heard the dialogue. One more time we'll listen to it, but for now you need to concentrate here. See, when you are talking of your plans, you can even ask this kind of questions. What are you getting up to this weekend? Did you get up too much at the weekend? I mean, what do you have to do at weekend? What you mean to say is this: what did you get up to in Chennai? Where are you going? If you are going to Chennai, what are you going to do there? That's why. Now, if these are the questions, what would be the answers? If somebody asks you these questions, how would you answer? Then your answers would be, I am going to Mumbai, or I am going to have a beach holiday, or I am visiting friends in Rajkot, or I am taking the family to a hill station, I am traveling across Kerala. These are some specimen answers that I have jotted down. You can use them as per your situation, you can change them, but these are just the sample answers. If somebody is asking you what are your plans of holidays, you might choose any of this and then you can speak English this way. I am going to Mumbai, or planning a beach holiday, or visiting friends, or I'm taking family to a hill station, or I'm traveling across Kerala. If you are not going there, then you can even say this: I am not sure yet. Maybe I'll head to the beach. You are not sure, that's why you are telling. If you have not made your plan, you can speak it this way: I am not sure yet. This is the sentence that you can use. I am not sure yet. Maybe I'll head to the beach. I'm pretty sure I'll have fun wherever I go. If the destination, if the place is not fixed, you can answer this way: that I do not know where I would go, but then wherever I'll go, I'll have lots of fun. Or you can answer it this way. I think I'll go to the mountains and get away from it all. Like I want to go away from the city life and I'll go to mountains. You can speak it this way. Or perhaps I'll stay at home. Got no money. Sometimes you can even say it this way. Like I don't have money to spend on holidays. That's why I'll stay at home. I mean, these are the possible answers that I could think of. And that's why I just jotted it down. Just wanted to give you hints on if somebody is talking to you about your holiday, what are the possible replies that you can give to them. Now here I've written a dialogue. This is one practice dialogue, the kind of dialogue that we have in textbook, but other than this, like one more dialogue of the same kind, one you have in textbook. One I have written for you. With the help of this dialogue and the textbook dialogue, you can write one for yourself. That's why I've written this dialogue for you. Two friends are discussing about their holidays and what kind of dialogue it can be. How this dialogue would go. Somebody says, A says, hooray, only 10 days to the holidays. Now there will be holidays in only 10 days. And B says, I know. I've been counting the days. I'm just sick of school. Like any of you, they are also sick of school and waiting for the vacations. That's why I say now they are counting days. Now only 10 days left and they are planning for their holidays. So one friend is asking, so am I. What are you going to do in these holidays? What are your plans? He is asking. And the other says, I should like to go to the hills for a change. But that means money. And I don't think my father will give it to me. He says, I want to be given a choice. If you ask for my liking or if you ask for my wish, I really want to go to the hills, mountains, but I don't have money. And I don't think my father will give me money. So I don't think I will be going anywhere. But then, by the way, he's asking the other friend. B asks, What are you going to do? Where are you going? And A says, oh, I shall go home. My home is in the hilly part where it is fairly cool in the summer. And I think I shall find plenty to do there. He is so excited to go back to his home. And luckily his home is in hills. So the weather is very pleasant there in summer season. And that's why he says, I am very excited. I will go home and then I'll enjoy. Then B says, you are lucky. My home is in the plains and it is very hot. And I soon get tired of the small village life. Because otherwise, even as we have seen in the previous slide, B anyhow wanted to go to the mountains. That's why he says, you are lucky. Your home also is in mountains. But then my home is in the plains. I stay in plain areas and that's why it is very hot there. And I don't like in small village, but my home is there. So he is not very excited. One friend is excited, the other is sad. Such is the situation. Then what happens next? A says, well, look here. Why not come to my home and stay with me for a few weeks? Now he has a suggestion. He is a real friend. He says, see, do one thing. Anyhow, I am going home and my home is in mountains. So why don't you also join and stay with me for a few weeks? B says, that would be fine. But I don't suppose your father would want me there. I should only be in the way. Like he says, I obviously it would be fun for me. I would like to come with you. But then he's scared of the friend's father. He says, perhaps your father would not approve of it. So it is better I should not dream of it and I should go my own way and I should go to my village. A says, not at all. Father told me last year when I was at home that I should bring one of my school fellows with me and have a good time. So come along. A says, not an issue at all. My father otherwise even told me last time when I went home, he asked me to come with my friend. Like, he asked me to invite my friends to my place. So if you come along, my father would not be angry at all. B is very happy. He says, I should love it. It's very kind of you. He is now happy. Throughout the dialogue, the tone of this person, B, was like disappointing and sad. Now he sounds a bit excited. He says, I should love it. It's very kind of you. A says, splendid. We can have some good time together. He's excited about it now. He's going home. He's going to the mountains. The weather also is fine. And moreover, his friend is also joining him. So he is also happy. B says, so we shall. He says, not only you, I will also enjoy. Both of us will have a good time. Thank you, buddy. You are my friend. Thank you. A says, oh, you need not thank me, because I shall myself have a much jollier time with you there than if I were alone. He says, don't thank me. You are a friend and I will enjoy you. I will enjoy with you more than had I been alone. So I am also happy that you are coming and both of us will enjoy each other's company. And that's how this dialogue ends with a happy tone. Both the friends decide to go to one friend's house, which is in mountain, and they would have a good time together. So this dialogue is written for you, just to give you a glimpse of one dialogue can be of this type. The other one is there in your textbook. Now you can read this both at your own pace and your own time. You can revise it time and again, and then you can write one dialogue yourself. You can write a dialogue on your own plans of how you are going to spend your holidays. You can write this practice dialogue that two friends are talking about, they are discussing their holiday plans. So read these two dialogues, sample dialogues, and then make one for your own self. Now we shall see the textbook dialogue once again as a sort of revision, and then we'll move on to the next. We are discussing holiday plans. We have seen the dialogue, and let us revise it one more time for you so that you get to have clear understanding, and then we will move on to the next.
Situation 9. Holiday plans. You visit many places during your holidays. Let's learn what and how to talk about your holiday plans. Here is one such dialogue.
What have you planned for your holiday?
I am going to Goa this October.
Wow, it's a beautiful place with amazing beaches. I went there 2 years back. I had lots of fun.
Yes, the weather there will be perfect in October.
How long will you be away?
I am planning a 5-day trip.
Good. You'll be completely relaxed. Are you taking your family along?
Yes, my parents and brother.
How are you going? By train or by air?
By train. We have booked our tickets. How about you? Going anywhere?
No, not this time. My cousins are coming to stay with us.
It sounds exciting.
Yes, we plan to go for shopping and eat out most of the time. There are so many shopping malls I have not visited yet.
And yes, during the vacation time, there will be many discount offers.
We have also planned to visit the Science City.
It's really good. You will enjoy with the group there.
Any new movie releases?
I'm not sure.
Anyway, enjoy your vacation in Goa.
I'm sure I will. And you too. Have a good time with your cousins.
This is the end of the dialogue. When one would ask you a question like, what do you do on a holiday? You would give the following answers.
I like reading. I like traveling. I like playing carom. I like relaxing. I like cooking.
Please note that exactly after the verb like, another verb comes with ing form. that is the present participle.
When one asks, how will you go there? You would answer by saying,
we will go there by air or by plane. We will go there by bus or by road. We will go there by train or by railway.
Please note that when we mention the means of transport, the preposition by is used before them.
You have seen a dialogue on friends discussing their holiday plans. You had the textbook dialogue, and then we saw one more dialogue also of the same sort. Moving on to the next dialogue is dialogue 10, and that is shopping at a mall. We all visit malls. We all go to malls for various purposes. I'm sure you would also be visiting malls for fun, for shopping. When you are going there, what kind of phrases would you use? What would be the correct usage? Which sentences you should use? This dialogue would teach you all those sort of things. So, if we see our textbook dialogue, visit to mall, let's see this first and then we will discuss it.
Shopping at a mall. You visit malls for shopping or entertainment. Let's learn what and how to talk when you visit malls for shopping. Here is part 1.
This is the biggest shopping mall in our town.
Does it have a good variety of things to choose from?
Yes, and it's quite reasonable also.
Do you have much shopping to do?
Yes, I have made a shopping list.
There are lots of shops. From where would you like to begin?
Let's begin with clothes.
But it seems that the section is crowded.
I need a raincoat and an umbrella. We will finish with that first.
That's a good idea.
Can we shop for clothes now?
What do you want to buy?
I want a shirt, perhaps a couple of them.
Do you have any particular color and style in mind?
Yes, dark blue color with broad stripes.
We will find it in the formal wear section.
I prefer the simple dark blue shirt. No designs, no patterns.
Yes, that looks good on you. It suits you.
Now, let's move to buy grocery. I want to eat something after that.
I am also very hungry.
If I ask you the question, does the shop have a good variety of things? Your reply could be,
yes, it's quite reasonable. Yes, it's quite good. Yes, but it's quite expensive. Yes, it's quite extraordinary.
Shopping at a mall. Here is part 2.
May I help you?
Yes, I would like to see your collection of sweaters.
Why not? Of course. Could you come this way, sir?
Could you please show me some new styles?
Sure, sir. All these sweaters are in vogue. It's the latest fashion.
I like this one. How much does it cost?
It's 1250 rupees only with a 12% discount since it's Wednesday.
Oh, thank you. Lucky me. Please pack it.
Here is your change. Please do come again. Thank you.
Thanks.
So, students, you have seen the textbook dialogue and I'm sure we all have come across this kind of situation. We are going to mall with a shopping list and we have so many things to do. The point is, what will you use? Like, what kind of correct usage you should have? Like, if you want to talk in English, if you want to speak English, then what should you use? So I've here tried to write down some useful expressions, some useful phrases that you can use while you are shopping at a mall. For example, if you are a customer there, then if you want to speak in English, you can say, I'm looking for dash, like I'm looking for shirts, or I'm looking for a sari, or I'm looking for whatever you are looking for is, I'm looking for a bag, a wallet, whatever it is. But the correct usage is, I am looking for, or I would like to buy. I would like to buy a bag. I would like to buy a compass box. Whatever it is, you can use this. Or you can use, I am looking for a pair of trousers, sports shoes, a DVD, whatever it is, I am looking for. I am looking for is the right expression. Or you can question them, do you have any pair of spectacles, or do you have any pair of formal jeans or formal trousers, whatever it is. Do you have these in a size smaller or bigger too? I want this, I like this, but then size is an issue. So do you have it in smaller or bigger size too? This you can ask them. You can even ask them, could you tell me where the dash is or are, where this section? If you are not able to locate the section which you are looking for, maybe say vegetables or books, then you can ask them, could you tell me where the books are or where the CDs are? Where can I find the dash section, vegetable section or grocery section? Do you sell dash? If you are not able to locate the thing that you are looking for, maybe say, for example, you are looking for a pencil cell, and if you are not able to see those in racks, you can ask them. You can ask the sales executive, do you sell pencil cells, for example? Or I need this, I need a pencil box, or I need a box of pencils, or I need gel pens. So then they will tell you, okay, where to find it. You can even ask them, could you tell me where the dash or is or are, where can I find the, or where can I look for this? All these expressions are not very difficult ones. Like, you can use them in your day-to-day life, and that's how you can get well acquainted with it, and you can feel more comfortable next time when you go to a shopping mall, a bigger one, and then you can find yourself a changed person, like if you speak it in English. You can even ask them, where can I find some vegetables? Do you work here? If you are not able to see somebody, and if you are not very sure, if they are not in uniform, if you are not sure whether the person is from the same mall or not, you can ask them, do you work here? Are you an employee here? Could you help me? Could I ask you something? Could is the expression. Could speaks of politeness. Could I ask you something? That should be the usage that you can have. Now, after all these expressions of customer, useful phrases are shop assistant says. Say, for example, if you are writing a dialogue and if you are a customer and a shop assistant, there are two characters given to you. I have given you a set of sentences for customers. Now, I am giving you set of sentences for a shop assistant. What a shop assistant would say. He would ask you, can I help you? Or he would ask you, are you looking for anything in particular? If you are roaming there for 10 minutes and if you are not able to locate whatever you want to find, so he can ask you, are you looking for anything in particular? May I help you? That way. Do you need any help at all? We don't have any of these left in stock. That is, if you are looking for something and the sticker is there, you can see the label, but you don't find the goods. So the shop assistant may tell you that the stock is over. We don't have this in stock, so don't look for them. You can choose from the other variety of things. Then, he can indicate a piece of clothing and then he can say, do you have this in medium, large? This is a customer's, in fact, dialogue. A customer can ask, do you have this in extra large, large, or this color, blue color or black color or beige color? Can ask them. The assistant can say, when you say thank you, he can say, you are welcome. Or here is your change. If you pay the money and if he is returning the money to you, he can say, here is your change. If you are looking for something and if you are now, he sees you are going towards the exit door, The salesperson may ask you, did you find everything you needed? Now your shopping is over. Could we satisfy your need? Did you find everything you needed? Or did you find what you were looking for? Our mall gave you everything that you were looking for. I mean, are you okay? This is just a customer feedback that a shop assistant is trying to take. Did you find everything okay? Any complaints or anything that you want to tell us? Generally, whenever we visit a shop or a mall, people, when we are leaving, people ask us this question. So if you are writing a dialogue between a shop assistant and a customer, all these expressions would help you. The shop assistant may even tell you there is a discount of 20% on this. These jeans are discounted by 20%, so that way he may attract you, that way he may get you tempted to buy things. It is a bargain. Bargain is like this. Generally, it is not so cheap, but today it is a sale. It is a bargain, so you can take it. It's cheap, it's expensive, whatever it is. Clothes shops have sales when some or all the clothes are discounted. So you can ask them, is this on sales or is this on sale? Like when you are not very sure whether everything which is put in that section is on sale or only some particular piece of clothing is on sale, you can ask them, showing them that piece, and then is this on the sales or is this on the sale? Whatever it is. When you are shopping is done, when you have collected whatever you wanted to buy and now you are on the counter, the phrases for the moment of payment and ending the conversation, when you are finishing off what you should speak and how he would reply. So if it is a salesperson would say, shall I gift wrap it? Salesperson can offer you this gift wrapping. He can ask you, would you like a bag? These days, everywhere, in any, shopping malls, even a small shopkeeper also would ask us for, would you like a bag? If we want a bag, we are charged some extra money. So this question is not a surprise. Would you like a bag? He may ask, tell us that comes to rupees, this many, 100, this many thousand, that comes to 1500, for example. Or here you are. That is, now you have paid the money and he is giving you the receipt, telling, here you are, sir, everything is over and thank you. So these are the expressions that salesperson may use. The customer can use the sentences like, that's all for today, that is it, thank you, that's all for today, I have finished off with my shopping list and then thank you. Or if you are not sure where to go, which side to go for payment, the customer may ask, where is the checkout? Where can I go and pay the money? Could I have a receipt, please? If he is not giving you the receipt and you needed receipt, you can ask for the receipt. Could I have a plastic bag, please? If you require a bag, you can ask them in such a way. I'm afraid, sorry, I don't have any change. If you don't have change, you can express it in this way, I'm afraid or I'm sorry, I don't have any change, you have to give me the change because I have finished off with my stock of change. Do you accept credit cards? If you don't want to pay by cash, but you want to use your card, then you can ask them this question. Do you accept credit cards? Can I pay with the help of my card or so? So these are some expressions a customer can use. Here, I have given you both the expressions. I have given you some phrases that a customer can use. I've also given you some phrases that a salesperson can use. So now I'm sure if somebody asks you or if there is a dialogue in examination about a salesperson and a customer, now with the help of your textbook dialogue and these expressions, you will be able to do it in a better way. So let us revise the textbook dialogue one more time and then that will be all for today. Let's see dialogue 10.
Situation 11. telephonic conversation.
Situation 10. Shopping at a mall. You visit malls for shopping or entertainment. Let's learn what and how to talk when you visit malls for shopping. Here is part 1.
This is the biggest shopping mall in our town.
Does it have a good variety of things to choose from?
Yes, and it's quite reasonable also.
Do you have much shopping to do?
Yes, I have made a shopping list.
There are lots of shops. From where would you like to begin?
Let's begin with clothes.
But it seems that the section is crowded.
I need a raincoat and an umbrella. We will finish with that first.
That's a good idea.
Can we shop for clothes now?
What do you want to buy?
I want a shirt. Perhaps a couple of them.
Do you have any particular color and style in mind?
Yes, dark blue color with broad stripes.
We will find it in the formal wear section.
I prefer the simple dark blue shirt. No designs, no patterns.
Yes, that looks good on you. It suits you.
Now, let's move to buy grocery. I want to eat something after that.
I am also very hungry.
If I ask you the question, does the shop have a good variety of things? Your reply could be...
Yes, it's quite reasonable. Yes, it's quite good. Yes, but it's quite expensive. Yes, it's quite extraordinary.
Shopping at a mall. Here is part 2.
May I help you?
Yes, I would like to see your collection of sweaters.
Why not? Of course. Could you come this way, sir?
Could you please show me some new styles?
Sure, sir. All these sweaters are in vogue. It's the latest fashion.
I like this one. How much does it cost?
It's 1250 rupees only with a 12% discount since it's Wednesday.
Oh, thank you. Lucky me. Please pack it.
Here is your change. Please do come again. Thank you.
Thanks.
We have seen both the dialogues, dialogue 9 and 10, and I've given tried to give you enough practice sentences, phrases and practice dialogue as far as both these topics are concerned. So now I am sure if in exam dialogue comes on any of this topic, whether you are discussing your holiday plan with your friend or whether you have gone to a shop and then you are talking to the salesperson, I'm sure you'll be able to frame both these dialogues very well. And students, remember, this is not only for your written practice. These expressions, these phrases, if you keep on practicing them, it would also improve your spoken English too. So, these all conversational skills are both the way beneficial to you. It would help you in your dialogue writing as well as it would enhance your spoken English skills too. So, I wish and hope that you all study well, acquire all good communication skills and flourish well in your life. Thank you.